you've been on set working with an amazing lineup of brilliantly talented people for Infinity Wars, and I'm curious, what's that experience been like? How did it compare with working with the rest of the Guardians game?
Well, I mean, both experiences were great individually. We've really built quite a family on the Guardians movies, and I love that cast so much. And then it was great to then work with see a lot of the old people, but also work with a new bunch of people on the Infinity War movies. I have so much respect for everyone that I worked with, and also for the people who put these casts together. I mean, it's Hollywood's kind of a strange place, and I gotta say, I've really enjoyed all of the people that I've been able to meet and learn from.
What about Joe and Anthony as directors? Obviously, a different experience from working with James, mm-hmm. I imagine.
I love Joe and Anthony. They're very different from my brother, but all directors are. And I also haven't known them since I was born, so that makes it a little different. But they're great. They and I like how they work off one another, and they're pretty unflappable. And I think that that's one area where they share with my brother is that they're very calm set presences, which can be hugely important in films like these.
The latest Infinity War trailer. What do you think of
Star-Lord?
He did Tony Stark. That was hilarious.
Yeah, I can't wait to see that on the big screen, but I have inside knowledge about a lot of that stuff, so again,
you're friends. Come on,
of course. Yeah. 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 What I say here stays here, right, guys?
We'll all pause the dictaphone for a second. Yeah. What's it like in the Rocket Raccoon suit?
Well, now, most of the stills that people see are from the first movie when I was wearing the green leotard. But in the subsequent films, I just wear a gray tracksuit, which is a lot more comfortable and less dorky looking than the leotard. So that's a little bit better. But yeah, no, I'm four movies now into doing Rocket on set, and I think sometimes I forget when actors show up for the first time who've never actually seen me do it, they get a little freaked out by like, whoa, that guy's really just getting down and walking on his, in a crouch position.
Is it method acting then, would you call it?
I don't root around and eat trash like raccoons do, I did have to dig on some of my drama school training of being an animal, getting down and being an animal.
Which character in Infinity War has the best reaction to a talking raccoon?
Oh, gosh. I think you're going to have to be the judge of that. Although it was certainly fun to see many of these new characters through the eyes of Rocket, because Rocket does not have the same sort of reverence for the superheroes that the average Earthling is going to have. So I think there's a lot of fun there.
More on that point, is there a scene where Rocket encounters a wild raccoon and sort of gets the revelation of, like, introspectively, like, who he is? Anything like that?
I can't comment on any scenes.
I think the real question is, who's taller, Rocket or Iron Man?
Who wears the biggest Cuban heels?
we need Kraglin to learn how to use that whistle, don't we?
We do.
If I'm going to have any sort of an imprint on the third movie, I think he better learn.
And obviously, we're going to hopefully have Kraglin back in a big capacity in the third movie, but I think it was interesting. Fans noticed that you're not listed as Kraglin on the cast list, on at least IMDb, for Infinity Wars, so... Mm-hmm. Is Kraglin not going to be a part of that, or are we going to see you in that capacity there?
I think I can't really answer. You won't see Kraglin in the first Infinity War movie, and then after you all see it, we can talk further after that, because a lot of things happen in that movie that bear on subsequent movies. So,
So I think obviously, I mean, in the last film, it was really nice to see Craiglin go from just a supporting character to really a full-fledged guardian. Is that something you're excited about with the third film? Has James sort of told you that's something that he's excited about?
Yeah, we've talked a little bit about, he tells me some, he gives me some hints here and there about what the plot will be like for the third movie. I haven't seen any words or seen any script, but he sort of will sit me down and say, it's kind of going this direction. And he's such a diligent planner that usually the way he says things are going to work out, they usually are pretty close to going that direction. So I don't know. I never get my hopes up. It's Hollywood. You're really not in the movie until the movie's finished. Which is a long ways from now, and I care more about the story than about the characters. So I just want the movie to be great. But anything that they ask me to do, I'll be ready to do for sure.